so tired of driving screws. I don't know how many screws I've drove, but I don't think I can drive anymore. Hey, hit the subscribe button. Let's get right into this thing. So guys, I started off by getting my back band board together. I actually took and put some Simpson strong time ending plates on one side, and I should have did it on both sides before trying to flip it over, or I should have just asked somebody for help, because you're about to see what happens. But I did drop it. I had to get it back up and flip it over, and thankfully it didn't mess those mending plates up. You know, they're really thin steel, so galvanized steel, so I was able to bend it back, and I put a mending plate on the other side, and it made it strong enough where I could maneuver it by myself and get it back in position. When I say back in position, I mean against the house. That's my back band board, and because there's nothing it's going to be setting on other than just a 6x6 where the two boards come together and it'll be bolted to the actual house itself. They don't sell 26-foot boards unless you special order something like an LVL, and I didn't want to do that, so I just mended these two boards together, and I put a brace where the joint is a 6x6 with a notch cut in it, but I'll show you a better picture of that here in a minute. Yes, I dropped it again, but it's strong enough with those mending plates on each side that it just kind of bows a little, and I can wrestle it back in position. Sometimes working by yourself can be difficult, but if you're hard-headed and got a strong will, you'll figure out how to get it done. So after getting that back in position, I measured on each side and got it even. I put you guys in time-lapse mode and I threw my sideboards up and my side rail bands, or whatever you want to call them, and put my front band on. And it's much easier because it can just lay on the seal plate. And you see this arrow here, I notched a 6x6 and I leveled that up and put a screw in just to hold it where the board is level. And then I notched a 6x6 for those two boards where they come together where those mending plates are. I notched a 6x6 for those to set on. That way it would have a support in the back. Plus I screwed that band board into the house itself. And then here you see me just cutting all my joists to run across. And I laid those out. I had to cut each one of them and lay them in there using treated 2x8. Material for my
guys. I almost got all the joist in. I'm just now I'm toe nailing one on each side, and then I still have to fasten all the front ones, pull them up and get them flush and fasten them. And then after I get those, I will take and come back underneath all these, and I got those little Simpson strong tie hangers I'll put up under each one on the back side. These will be sitting on this ledge in the front. But these, I'm gonna put those Simpson strong tie things for them to set in.
So here I'm actually going and fastening the front now. I think I did 3 or 4 screws per 2x8 in the front. And I took my speed square and did my 16-inch layout down the front and back band boards. And you know, some of that wood can be a little warped, so I actually have a trick on how to straighten a warped board and get it lined up to your marks, if you want to check that out on my channel. Here you can see I had to mend 2 pieces I had left over from my band boards to make my last board, which is fine. It ended up falling super close to my outer band board, so I really didn't have to put it in there, but I just went ahead and did it. And here I put all my joist hangers on. I used Simpson strong tie joist hangers, and their strong tie structural screws. I slowed the video down a little bit so you could see how they hook on the bottom and then two screws on each side of it.
All right, guys, I got the wife out here. She helped me square it up. So it's square now. And I took and got some of these strong tie anchor bolts, big flat-headed anchor bolts, about every 4 foot down through there. I ran one of those in, and I got this spaced off. It's just something I did. I don't know if it's technically the way you're supposed to, but it's how I did it. I spaced this a quarter inch off of the house, and I figured if rain comes and hits here, it'll run down the house wrap, and the house wrap underneath this already has a piece of metal flashing down here, which is actually your vinyl hook. And I figured water would go down and go over house wraps over that metal flashing and go right out the bottom, and that'll keep water from rotting that board out. That's my train of thought. If you wouldn't have done it that way, just go ahead and leave a comment below. It won't bother me one bit. But I'm gonna lay these decking boards up, and then what I plan on doing is coming back and running me a piece of J channel across the bottom, and then I'll just pop my other piece of vinyl back in and cut it where it fits down that J channel nice. And I believe that'll work, guys. But we're gonna start laying decking boards now, and I'll put you in time-lapse mode for that. Now, guys, I end up taking a ton of footage and time-lapse videos of me putting decking boards on. But after I put them in this video, I realized that watching me screw decking boards on is very, very boring. So I cut out probably 90% of me putting the decking boards on. Because even in time-lapse mode, it's just super slow because there's like 19 or 20 joists you have to screw every board in down through there. The brother-in-law and sister-in-law actually stopped by here one day, and he helped me put 4 or 5 boards on. And other than that, I put them all in, except the wife helped me put a few on. But you know, it really takes quite a bit of time to screw each individual board on, and I put 2 screws per joist in every single decking board. And you know, that makes a good solid deck. It's nice and quiet, don't squeak when you walk. And I actually didn't even get a video, I didn't get it in the video, but around the perimeter of my band boards, I got some 90 degree corner brackets, and I did 6 of them. I put those corner brackets on the actual band boards and screwed them down to the seal plate to keep it square and to keep everything from moving. So guys, if you look here, we're getting her knocked out. It's looking pretty good. I was cutting all the boards to length, but I don't remember, or I give credit where credit's due. I seen someone on YouTube. It may have been the Perkins Builder Brothers, or maybe Ken's Carpentry, I'm not sure, but I seen where they let the boards run long, take a chalk line and snap it, and then just cut them all at once instead of taking time to cut each individual board. So I started doing that, just letting them run long on this end, and then we ran the run out, and then when I got down there where I can start using the cutoffs, I'm gonna cut this backside off, and I'll use those cutoffs up here to finish these runs out. It's starting to look good though. Almost looks like a deck. I'll give you guys a front view too. Like I said, I tried cutting each board individually and coming up with an even on the end, but I found that this way is much, much easier. Just run your boards long, measure out where you want each end, and snap it with a chalk line, and
You get super accurate cuts. Every board is completely even because you cut them all at the same time. So guys, like I said, I cut out a bunch of video of me putting these decking boards down, and I hope y'all don't mind. I mean, to me, it would have just been boring to watch me put down every single board, but I kind of skimmed through it here and skipped from here to there and let you kind of see the completion of it. And here you can see that we're getting pretty close to the end of it. And I was glad to see the finish line. My knees definitely were. Crawling around putting these things down was pretty rough on the old knees. Hey guys, I appreciate y'all tuning in for part three of this build. It may not look like the deck's finished, but I'm not going to tell you why. You'll have to tune in to the next video, which will hopefully be out next week, on why I left those last two deck boards off. And that'll give you a reason to come back and check out the next build in this series. But I do appreciate y'all watching. I appreciate all of our subscribers, all of our new subscribers. I did enjoy that little dance with my baby girl on that after all that hard work. I mean, driving in almost 1,000 screws is like crazy to do it just one man. I think my brother-in-law helped me put down just a couple boards, maybe 4 or 5 at the most, but it was crazy to put that many screws in just a day or so, but when that's just working in the evenings. But hey, we got it done. Well, almost done. Still got to do the roof and some other things, but y'all tune in next week to see what we got going on here at GK Building. Appreciate it, guys.